Hey everybody, it's Wednesday. I'm Matthew Laria, and you're watching the Faith for Life broadcast. Let's pray and release faith over today's broadcast, and then we're going to get right into the Word. Father, we do thank you again today, Lord, for your Word. We ask you again today for revelation of it. We ask you for grace and help to hear it, to receive it, to put it into practice, and to see it work in our lives, and we do thank you for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, all this week on the broadcast, we're doing a series of teachings entitled, God Wants Me Well. And this week on the broadcast, we're answering the question, is healing the will of God? Is it the will of God for my life? Is it the will of God for your life? And we are getting rooted in this truth that God wants me well. Come on, friends, say it with me. God wants me well. Now let's go over to Matthew chapter 8 again, and let's begin reading there in verse 2. And it says this, "And behold, there came a leper and worshiped him, saying, Lord, if you will, you can make me clean. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed." The Phillips translation says this, "If you want to, you can make me clean." And it says, "Jesus stretched out his hand and placed it on the leper, saying, of course I want to." I love that part. "Of course I want to be clean." And at once he was clear of his leprosy. What's God's attitude in regard to healing? His attitude is, "Of course I want to." You see, friend, the breaking down and deterioration of the physical body was never God's will and was never God's plan. The breaking down of the physical body came with the fall. In Genesis chapter 3, verse 19, after Adam sinned, God said this, "Till you return unto the ground, for out of it you were taken, for dust you are, and dust you shall return." And so what is that? That's the dying. That's the breaking down of the physical body. And that didn't happen until after man sinned. And when man sinned, death entered into the world. And the effect that death had on the physical body is that it caused the physical body to break down, to deteriorate until it died. And sickness and disease falls under that. It falls under the deterioration of the physical body. And that was never God's will. That was never God's plan for your body, for my body, for man's body. See, it's the enemy who's behind the destruction of the physical body. John 10:10 says, "The thief comes not but for to steal, to kill, and destroy." And it's the enemy who wants to destroy people's bodies, wants to cause their bodies to break down and to deteriorate. That's what he wants, and he's behind it. He's the one behind sickness and disease, breaking down people's bodies. It was never God's plan, never God's will that that would happen. God likes our bodies to be strong. God likes our bodies to be healed and to be whole and to be well. In the beginning, before man sinned, our bodies, man's bodies, didn't get sick. They didn't break down. They didn't deteriorate. Why? Because that's not what God liked. God likes it when our bodies are strong. God likes it when our bodies are whole. God likes it when our bodies are well. And we can see that in the beginning in God's creation. And then in the end, after the enemy is fully defeated and put away, we are going to get glorified bodies that will never die or never get sick again. Well, why would God do that? Because that's what he likes for our bodies. In 1 Corinthians 15, it reveals that to us about our bodies. In verse 53, it says that this corruptible body must put on incorruption, and this mortal body must put on immortality. And so with no enemy, when the enemy wasn't present, man started with a healed body, And when the enemy is not present in the end, man will finish with a healed body. Why would that be? Because God likes our bodies healed. And here's the good news. In the middle of that, in the middle of the beginning and the middle of the end where we're living right now, we can be healed and walk in healing and receive healing for our bodies by and through our own faith. But I want you to lay hold of the reality that the breaking down of the body, God's not into it, and He doesn't like it. It wasn't that way in the beginning. It won't be that way in the end. Why? Because that's not what God likes. God likes our bodies healed. God likes our bodies whole. God likes our bodies strong. God likes our bodies well. That's what He likes, and that is actually available to the believer in this life. And friend, if you see someone broken down in their body and think that God likes it that way, then you don't know of the one of whom you speak. I want to say that to you again. If you see someone broken down in their body, riddled with sickness and disease, being eaten up by something terminal, and you think that God likes it that way, you know not of the one you speak, because God does not like that. God is not into that. He's not into somebody being eaten up by disease, eaten up by sickness, and their body just riddled with it and broken down by it. God's not into that. He doesn't like it. And if you think He is, then you don't know Him, because if you knew Him, you'd know He doesn't like that. And He's not into that. God is a God of life. And healing is a life thing. God likes things to be strong. He likes things to be thriving. He likes things to be prosperous and healthy, not broken, not battered, not weakened. God is a God of life, and healing is a life thing. God is also a good God. In Psalm 119, verse 68, it says this, You are good and you do good. Let me read that to you again. You are good and you do good. See, God is a good God, and healing is a good thing. In Acts chapter 10, verse 38, it talked about how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed of the devil. He did good and healed. Why? Because healing is a good thing, and our God is a good God, and He is into healing because healing is good. Come on, sickness and disease, bad. Healing, good. Our God is a good God, and He's into healing because healing is a good thing. Our God is also a God of love. 1 John 4:18 says, God is love. And friend, 3 John 2 says this, Beloved, I wish above all things that you prosper and be in health even as your soul prospers. Beloved, I wish, I pray above all things that what? That you prosper and you be in health. See, when you love someone, you don't want to see them sick. Come on, you don't want to see them broken down and ravished by disease in their body. No, when you love someone, you want to see them walking in health. And our God is a God of love, and He loves us, and healing is a love thing. He wants to see us healthy. He wants to see us walking in health. God also wants us blessed. He wants us to walk in blessing. And healing is a blessing. Sickness and disease is a curse. You can go to Deuteronomy 28, and that chapter lays out the blessing and the curse. And all throughout the curse, you see sickness and disease. Why is that? Because sickness and disease is a curse. Healing is a blessing. In Deuteronomy 7:15, it says this, You shall be blessed above all people, and the Lord will take away all sickness from you. You're going to be blessed, and the Lord's going to take away all sickness from you. What does that reveal to us? That reveals to us that sickness and disease is a curse and healing is a blessing, and God wants you and I blessed. In Galatians 3:13, it says that Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, being made a curse for us, so that the blessing of Abraham might come on the Gentiles. Jesus became a curse so that you and I could be blessed. Sickness and disease is a curse, and healing is a blessing. God wants us blessed, and healing is a blessing. God is into us being blessed. He's into us being healed. This is the kind of God that we serve. And friend, I want to say that to you again. If you see someone riddled and broken down with sickness and disease in their body and disease ravishing their body, and you think that's what God wants, then you don't know of the one of whom you speak. We serve a God of life. We serve a good God. We serve a God of love. We serve a God who wants us blessed. And healing is a life thing. Healing is a good thing. Healing is a love thing. Healing is a blessing thing. And this is what God wants for our lives. It has never been and never will be the will of God for His people to be hurt, sick, or oppressed in their physical bodies. I need to say that to you again. It never has been and never will be the will of God for His people to be hurt, sick, or oppressed in their physical bodies. You know, in Matthew 8:17, it says this, that Jesus Himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. And friend, if God wanted you to have it, if He wanted me and you to have sickness and disease on our bodies, then Jesus never would have took it. He took it because He didn't want us to have it. Come on, God wants us well. Say that with me again. God wants me well. This is good news, isn't it? Now, as we're closing today's broadcast, friend, I want to remind you of these three things. Number one, the breaking down and deterioration of the physical body was never God's plan or never God's will for mankind. Number two, if you see someone broken down in their body and think God likes it, you know not of the one you speak. And then number three, it never has been and never will be the will of God for His people to be hurt, sick, or oppressed in their bodies. God wants us well. Let's pray. Father, Lord, we thank You today that You want us well. We thank You today that You want us healed in our bodies. And Lord, we just ask You to help us to get rooted strong in that truth. And we do thank You for it. In Jesus' name, amen. Friend, thank you so much for watching today's broadcast. Now, don't forget to come back tomorrow for Thursday's edition of our Faith for Life broadcast. And we're going to continue this series, God Wants Me Well. We'll see you then.